إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، أيها المسلمون، عباد الله. My dear brothers and sisters, over the next few weeks, or rather months, we will, by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, study together the life or the biography, what we know as in Arabic as as-seerah, the biography of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We will be discussing the life of the greatest man to ever have lived, the greatest man to step foot on this earth from Adam alayhi salam until the last man that will walk on the face of this earth. We will be speaking about the most beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, when He created the creation, He chose and He selected from them, He preferred from all of His creation the Anbiya or the Prophets. And then from these Prophets, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala selected and He preferred al-Rusul or the Messengers. And from these Messengers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala selected those five known as Ulul Azm, those with great determination. And they were Nuh, and Ibrahim, and Musa, and Isa, and Muhammad alayhim as-salatu was-salam. And then from those five selected messengers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose one, and he is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was chosen over all of the prophets, over all of the messengers, and over those five highly regarded messengers as well. He, salawatu rabbi wa salamuhu alayhi, was the seal of our Prophet, Allah Jalla wa Ala chose Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to come with that message in its final form. As a matter of fact, we find from the hadith of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu wa arghah in the Sahihain, meaning in Sahih al-Bukhari, in Sahih Muslim, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says regarding himself. And note here that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was not speaking about himself because he was conceited, but rather we have to always keep in mind the words of Allah jalla wa ala when he says, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. And he does not speak from his own desires. So when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam speaks about himself, when he's praising himself, this is not something he is doing for his own benefit. This is revelation, divine revelation, which had been revealed to him by Allah jalla wa ala, and he was ordered and he was commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to relate it to us. So what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us about his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Through him, that is through his messenger. He says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَثَلِي وَمَثَلُ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ قَبْلِي the likeness of me and that of the messengers or the prophets that came before me is that of a man who builds a fantastic building, a wonderful and a beautiful looking building. He beautifies it and he tries to perfect it, except that he leaves out in one of its corners just the space of one brick. And the people come to this building and they start admiring it. They look at this building and they are amazed at how wonderful it is, how beautiful it is, except that they notice this one brick that is missing. And they say, هَلَّا وُضِعَتْ هَذِهِ اللَّبِنَةِ, that shouldn't it be that this brick now should be placed in this spot? And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to them, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to them, فَأَنَا اللَّبِنَةِ وَأَنَا خَاتَمُ النَّبِيِّينَ. He said that I am that missing brick and I am the seal of the Prophet. So in other words, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected his message through his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected this deen for us through Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No one, wallahi, no one but no one understands the value and the status of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam besides Allah jalla wa ala. None of us knows just what a great man he was, and none of us truly realizes the value of this man Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look to the Quran and you see how Allah jalla wa ala praises him and purifies him in every way. Alam nashrah laka sadrak مَا زَاغَ الْبَطَرُ وَمَا طَغَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praises his messenger and he purifies him from head to toe. And Allah jalla wa ala praises him with the greatest of praises when he says to him, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. And indeed, you are on the best moral character. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honors his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in many ways. Amongst those ways, if we look to the Quran, we find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath and he swears by many things. But never ever did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swear by the life of anyone besides the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All of those prophets and messengers that passed, Allah Jalla wa Ala never swore on their life to anything. But he said, وَلَعَمْرُكْ, addressing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, and by your life, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّهُمْ لَفِي سَكْرَتِهِمْ يَعْمَهُونَ. So he swore by the life of his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, concerning, of course, the disbelievers, that indeed they were in their intoxication, wandering blindly. You want to know how Allah Jalla wa Ala honored his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Again, look to the Quran. You will find in many places that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses his messengers and his prophets directly by name. Ya Adam, uzkur anta wa zawjaka al-jannah. يا عيسى إن متوفيك ورافعك إني متوفيك ورافعك إلي. يا يحيى خذ الكتاب بقوة. يا زكريا إنا نبشرك بغلام. So Allah جل وعلا addresses his prophets and his messengers by their name. O عيسى